and make it easy on yourself. Make it easy on yourself.
Because he's wearing red glasses these days.
By the way,
yeah.
How's Porky's Lyme disease this morning, Alan? I think he's got liar's disease myself, says Mick and Lester.
How dare you say that? Lyme disease is a very serious complaint.
Oh, another one, can you tell Muppet Paddy, Alan, that Alan Ball was from Bolton. It was Bolton born and bred, not Blackpool, you idiot. Dan in Bolton.
Excuse me, who's that come from? That comes from Dan. Yeah, Dan, let me just tell you this before you start calling me an idiot. I know exactly where Alan Ball was brought up, and Alan Ball, his father, Senior, actually had a coaching job at Preston. But Alan Ball was taken on by Blackpool, you
now, where
Muppet.
Where was he born?
He's born in Bolton, I know that. He's
born just outside said Blackpool
Bolton.
A moment ago. Yes,
I did not. He was taken on by Blackpool. That's where he rose to prominence, and he was still playing for Blackpool when he won the World Cup. So don't Muppet me, pal, because I'll
Muppet
you.
Chris, this is Chris, he says. Alan, Porky telling Porkies yet again.
Mm-hmm.
I wish it could be Christmas every day, only reach number 4. He knows nowt about music, unlike you, Alf. Thank you.
Oh, that's very nice. Yeah, go on. Why don't you lavish Mr. Brazil with praise, you numpty?
Any truth that Porky got his Rolex off a second-hand seller in Petticoat Lane?
No, I didn't.
Perhaps.
No, I did not.
And another one, Alan, I was half expecting a marriage proposal then from Porky to Joe Royal.
Listen, there is nothing wrong with being respectful to giants of the game.
Well, why'd you get on your knees?
I didn't get on my knees. How dare you? Now, listen, we want to hear from you all this morning, folks.
The last time you were on your knees, I was telling the story.
Yes.
I was up in NEC, Birmingham. I was telling the story.
Yeah.
About when we were in Cheltenham, because Cheltenham's just round the corner, isn't it?
Yes.
And I've got to tell the listeners this. I'll be brief, right?
Oh, you've got to tell them.
So we are broadcasting from a fantastic Lord Vestey's box at Cheltenham, okay? So Porky brings 2 bottles of bubbly Tuesday. I bring it Wednesday. Porky gets hammered, forgets Thursday to bring 2 bottles.
Not true.
So I'm broadcasting from the box at Cheltenham, about to throw 2 travel. I said, Porky, where's the bubbly? 8 o'clock in the morning. We always have a glass of bubbly, right? He said, I'm sorry, I was a bit late. I said, where's the bubbly? I forgot. I said, well, get your head under that table. Lord Vestey has all these guests, beautiful clarets and great wine. I said, get your backside under there and find a bottle of bubbly for 8 o'clock. It's tradition.
Yeah, you see, and you've got a problem, haven't you?
As he's scuffling under the table, the door opens, and he can't hear. You know, and he said, I think I've got one. It's in a box. So get it home, get him. And as I look up, the door opens. This guy walks in immaculate into the box. Beautiful morning suit, bowler hat on. And as he takes one step forward, Porky emerges from under the tablecloth, says, pow, ow, here we go, a bottle of Dom Pom. And as he holds it up, the fella just looks at him. He's on his knees, he is grovelling.
No.
And I'm now having to throw to travel. Talks about travel, 7:45, back in a moment. And as I look round, Porky's saying, I'm so sorry, Lord, on his knees. I am so sorry. I promise you, 10 o'clock, I was going right down to the town. I was going to replace not just 1 bottle, 2 bottles to you, Lord. And he rambled on for about 3 minutes, and the guy suddenly said, get up, you dope. I'm Lord Vestey's butler.
Yeah, well, I mean, look, anybody could have made that mistake in the way he was dressed. And anyway, that's not quite an accurate story, because it didn't really happen like that. Listen, folks, we want you to contact us on the show this morning, so you can get us by texting us on 81089 50p, plus normal sending charges apply, or tweet us at TalkSport or at MikeParry8.
Well, Brad has done exactly that. He says, Alan, Alan, has Porky been on the old bladderation trial already this morning?
No.
I hope he sobers up for tomorrow night. Poor old MG, he says, says Brad.
Yeah, poor old MG. MG, I mean, crikey, MG, I have to carry him on stage sometimes in those live shows we do. Tomorrow night, Sunday, at the Shepherd's Bush Empire. Now then, that...
Have they opened the upper stalls yet, or are you still struggling to sell tickets?
No, we're not struggling to sell tickets, Al. The theatre is full, put it that way.
Is Porky spending Christmas up at Big Brenda's?
No. There is no Big Brenda, I keep telling you. Now, you say you were at Annabelle's last night, Al, and obviously... Obviously, that's an elitist sort of institution, because you no longer mix with the sort of the common man, do you?
I was at the casino afterwards.
Well, you know, the common man doesn't often get into a casino and start lavishing the chips on
the
table.
Steve Bomas was in there, old Steve.
Oh, Steve, he lives near me. That's right, yeah, he's bought the field next to his house that used to have horses in it, but I think he's got plans for it. Good for him. Now,
and make it easy on yourself.
Easy on yourself. Oh. breaking up is so very hard to do.